what you produce is you produce it in your liver when you're starving or when you're on the Atkins diet or a ketogenic diet. And what they do is they produce from the fat. So when you start to starve, you mobilize the fat, goes to your liver, and then you produce ketones, which are very small molecules. And the molecules, and you need ketones to keep the brain going, so that when you're not eating, when you're not eating, you're not taking any glucose, and your brain can only survive on glucose. It can't survive on fat. So we've got fat, most foods are fat, carbohydrate, or a protein. But now we've got ketones. So what happens is, we made an ester, okay? And what happened was, we said, all right, we're going to make some sort of way of breaking down ketones slowly in the intestine, okay? So we thought, all right, well, we can have polymer, we have all these different things. And so we spent the first several years talking to chemists all around the world. So, you know, sort of we tried all different things. We tried supercritical CO2, and we just tried all these things around the world. And finally, we ended up talking to Jeremy Robinson here in chemistry, and he made us a whole lot of polymers and made and esters. And what happened was that we thought, all right, well, we were trying them in rats to see how they broke down the gut, because we needed them to break down over time, so that you have one drink, and then over time they broke down. So you couldn't keep drinking them all the time. So if you went to Sigma and bought a beta hydroxybutyrate from Sigma, A, you pay a ton, you know, it's £100 for a couple of milligrams. But not only that, you would never, ever be able to drink enough, because you'd either get the acid, which would eat away your stomach, or a salt, which would just overload you so much that you wouldn't be able to survive anyway. So you can't just go and do that. So we made an ester. And the ester, we ended up having an ester. And the reason that we did that was because we have lots of esterases in our blood and in our gut. And many of our foods come as esters. Okay. So you can break them down, they bring up your level, and it stays up over time. Okay. All right, so here we have our ester coming in. We have our ketone drink. It's broken down by gut esterases and into beta hydroxybutyrate and butanediol. Butanediol goes into the liver and is broken down to beta hydroxybutyrate and acetoacetate, which is also a ketone molecule, which is taken up. And the reason it works so well is it's taken up instantaneously. So it goes straight through those monocarboxylate transporters and into the mitochondria. And it's just fantastic. So the reason that it's such an efficient fuel is because of the way it's taken up very rapidly, it's taken in straight into the mitochondria where it makes NADH at beta hydroxybutyrate, dehydrogenase. So you're making NADH, which feeds straight into the electron transport chain. But not only that, it feeds also into the TCA supplement. So you're feeding in. So there are several reasons why it's the most efficient fuel you would have. And glucose, there's a limit to the rate at which glucose can be taken up from the gut. But not only that, you've got to go through glycolysis, and there's all these limits to glycolysis. And fatty acids, again, limits to how fast it's taken up, and beta oxidation takes a while. So the ketones being small molecules and being taken up very rapidly, making NADH for the electron transport chain, make it really, really efficient. That's good. Okay, so we had Jeremy Robinson making all these different things in chemistry, and we had to decide on which one we wanted. Okay, so he made diesters and monoesters and goodness knows what. And what we had to do was we had to try them, because we had to know what they tasted like. So here we had a chemist, and the first time we did it, you know, he gave us all these little pots of things that had been made, and we started trying them. He just looked horrified, absolutely horrified. He said, you know, you can't eat this, and, you know, we're saying, but it's going to be a food. We have to eat it. We have to know what it tastes like. And so he looked rather horrified. And then after a while, he started trying them himself. He said it was the only time that he, as a chemist, had ever eaten anything he'd ever made. So anyway, so that was quite fun. Anyway, so we spent quite a few years trying these different chemicals until we came up with the one that we've got. So what we've actually got is, instead of just the food being divided into three, which is protein, carbohydrate, and fat, we now have ketones. So we now have a drink of ketone that you